BMW has just reported the Q3 earnings and the company is doing great. Profit rose almost by 10% thanks to excellent performance in China. More importantly, the company announced the new electric crossover iNext. Or shall I say iX? Hit that subscribe button and let's figure out together.
Bakunin Live.
BMW has been hyping the introduction of a new electric crossover since quite a while. For the first time, BMW iNext was unveiled at Paris Motor Show back in 2018. But the new name they're giving to this new crossover is actually iX. By the way, they already have iX3, so why don't you give iX5 or iX6 to this new beautiful car? Isn't it confusing? Many reviewers on YouTube started immediately comparing BMW iX with Europeans with Audi e-tron, Mercedes EQC and Jaguar I-Pace in the premium segment. I do think it's a big mistake, and I will explain you why. Look at the sales result of Q1 2020 in the US. Number one in the premium segment is Tesla Model 3, and it has the market share of 21%. BMW comes second, but with the entire lineup of like small and medium cars. You have BMW 2, 3, 4 and 5 combined and they only have 15%. If I were a German CEO, I wouldn't sleep well with these outstanding results. I would even say for the first time in the modern history, German car makers are chasing Americans here. So today we're going to compare BMW iX with Tesla Model Y. But before we get into technical details, let me first have a look at the exterior of this vehicle. It has the footprint of X5, the roof height of X6, and actually the wheel size of X7. All lines are straight and clear, each line has its own place, and there are no redundant lines on this car. Look at this kidney-shaped grille. Do electric cars really need it? No, obviously no, but it's BMW's signature, what else I have to say here? I love those integrated door handles, but what are those bright blue highlights? Aren't we in 2020 already? Look at this premium interior. It really feels like a living room, and this is what BMW designers are saying. They are saying they were fully inspired by autonomous drive, but you will see it later. Actually, we don't have that many details about driver assist systems. Nevertheless, I think they get the point and give that extra comfort for passengers in the vehicle. You can see this hexagonal steering wheel and two nice large screens behind it. The first one is 12.3 inch and the second one is almost 15. It's a 5-seater and here I already start comparing this one to Tesla Model Y. You already know that Tesla Model Y will come as a 7-seater in 2021. And now let's do the technical comparison. By the way, I was looking and searching for different numbers and values. You know, you can find different information and I'm sure before they release this vehicle officially and deliver to the market, some numbers may change. So don't quote me on this, but it will give you more or less a good impression of what's going on here, especially if you compare it with Tesla Model Y. BMW iX has an impressive battery pack. The company is saying it will have 100 kilowatt hours of capacity. This is really huge, and if you compare to Tesla, they only have 75. There were rumors actually this summer that Tesla is working on a 100 kilowatt hour battery pack for Tesla Model 3, but those rumors were not confirmed by Elon Musk. But let's look at the driving range. Some people are saying it's 300 miles, some people are saying it's closer to 370. If you compare it to Tesla Model Y, it will be 326 for the model which is called Tesla Model Y long range. And this is where it starts really bothering me, because with that large and impressive battery pack, if you're only able to deliver 300 miles, there is definitely something going wrong here. I hope the number will be higher, but before we get this certification by EPA, I wouldn't really judge here. BMW announced the DC fast charging speed. It's gonna be 200 kilowatts, which is 50 kilowatts less than what Tesla is offering today, up to 250 if you use a supercharger. But more importantly, where are you gonna charge at that speed? In US or in Europe, the availability of those quick chargers is not that high, and I can tell you that because I also own an electric car, and I was hardly able to find a CHAdeMO charger in California which can deliver 100 kilowatt of power. I will be comparing the all-wheel drive versions of both vehicles, and what's impressive about BMW iX, they are offering us 500 horsepower, which is exceptional and much better if you compare it to long range. It's only 384, but if you go to performance version of Tesla Model Y, that can be actually very close to 500 horsepower. I couldn't find any official numbers, but there are some independent tests that are suggesting that we can actually achieve 500 horsepower on Tesla Model Y performance. With that enormous power, BMW iX gives you acceleration just below 5 seconds, which is easily on par with Tesla Model Y long range. But if you look at performance again, it's only 3.5 seconds. Top speed is not impressive neither. It's 124 compared to Tesla Model Y performance of 155. As I said in the very beginning, BMW designers were absolutely inspired by autonomous features, and that's why the interior of this vehicle would be so luxurious and comfortable, just giving you a feeling of a living room in your home. But when it comes to disclosure and information available about those features, we don't see much. However, we all know well that Tesla has this enormous FSD package which costs $10,000, and they recently released the new software update which gives you the functionality of level 3 driving. I'm saying level 3 precisely because it still requires a human monitoring of the system, but it still gives you much more comfort and confidence on the road. I wish BMW would offer something similar in the future, and they still have almost 1 year to go. They announced the 5G functionality. I hope they are working on it, and as I said, the vehicle will be released in November 21, which means in 1 year they would probably work harder on this and announce something, I hope, very, very impressive. If you looked in some reports, for instance Euro NCAP, they were actually comparing the ADAS features of various car makers, and Tesla didn't come first in Europe. Germans were doing much, much better. There were reasons for that, that's for sure, but do I believe in BMW and its capabilities to deliver level 2 plus or level 3? The short answer is yes. When it comes to conclusion, it will be actually very hard to conclude and tell you anything about a potential success of BMW iX without knowing ADAS capabilities and also price. Some guesses in the web are saying the price tag will be roughly $40,000 plus, which I personally don't believe with this huge and enormous battery pack, which will be roughly half of the cost of this vehicle. You cannot be at that price level in the market. If you want to buy Tesla Model Y long range today, you would need to pay $49,900. If you are buying performance, it's close to $60,000, plus various features, plus FSD functionality can be up to $10,000 and plus. If BMW really wants to succeed and actually grab some market share from Tesla in this segment, they need to get pricing right. They need to announce good functionality. They need to offer some good driver assist systems. And when you compare SOP, start of production, it's November 21, which it's actually at the same timing of Gigafactory launch in Germany, which means Tesla is already there in Europe and competing with BMW, Mercedes and Volkswagen on their own turf in their own backyard. Let's hope BMW executives can watch this video and make the final effort to get closer to its competition and be successful in the markets in their home market, but also in the US. If you like that video, hit that subscribe button, ring the bell, stay tuned, Bakunin.